All right. Time to get this bad boy baked out. Right. Okay, so yesterday I got the, or first of all, welcome back everybody who's been following along. Yesterday was not the smoothest day, but I got everything done earlier today. I did the retopology and turned out pretty good. I don't know if you guys can see that here. Let me change the a little easier to see. My low poly. Pretty decent retopo. I was having some issues with the shrink wrap. Like, it does all these weird things and it kind of goes in spots that you don't want it to go. Like right here. But I think it'll be okay. Anyways, what I do when I take my objects into Marmoset, I split them up into separate pieces. So on this layer, I have the same exact object, but I have it all split up into separate parts. For example, this is I call it the box low, the right lid low, left lid low, lock low. And then I have all the corresponding parts over here in the first layer with the high poly. So I have the box low, lid right low, lid left low. And what I do from there is I export them into Marmoset Toolbag. So I've already exported them as FBX. I have my chest high, my chest low. And so we'll just do a quick save. So just in case something goes wrong, I'll go ahead and close Blender. Or yeah, I'll just leave it open. I got Marmoset. Let me pull that down here. And Marmoset, you just hit the little bread loaf of bread icon here. And you hit the load, quick loader, load button. And you just load your models. Well, that's doing that. Also, one other thing I do just to keep things simple in Marmoset, I put the same material on all the parts. So there's only one material, but a bunch of separate parts exported as an FBX. Let me turn this music on. I've been using this Pretzel app, and Facebook keeps telling me that I'm playing copyrighted music, and then, as far as I know, the Pretzel music app is, that's what it's for, is to stream music that's DRM free or whatever. Not DRM, music copyright protection free, I don't know what. But anyways, hopefully they won't put me off. I'm gonna keep it a little low, so just so that there's something in the background. Okay, so back to Marmoset. We got our object in here. Let me see if I can get a better sky in here. Here we go. I think that'll make it a little more visible for you guys. Stick a little ground plane. So you go back to the baker and you just kind of go through your objects, the metal bands. You can see the cage. You don't have to worry about it intersecting with any of the other objects because it's technically on its own. Man, I was worried about that. In my hinges here, the sky is really not working out to look at it. Oh, no. Let's try that one. Not much better. But right here between the hinges, the cage is intersecting on itself, so I have to let's see if I can make it a little smaller. Chest. Fakes. No, we'll just call it chest. And then it'll give it the name, like normal, ambient occlusion, etc. So yeah, I'm working on this intersection here. Let me turn everything else off so it's a little easier to illustrate. All right, now I have just the metal bands out. Oh yeah, see, it's make the cage too small, it's missing. Out of the So what you can do is you can paint offset. Yeah, that's the one. Make this big. Guess you can't make it. Okay, if I figure it out right. Luckily, I kind of know what the things look like. I think if I use the black, whoa, a little too aggressive. Maybe it's on this side. So yeah, it is in this side. I think I can turn the value down. Oh, I like a dark gray. Yeah, it's this one right here. Come on, undo. If I can actually get it so you can see it. It takes a second for it to like catch up, kind of. Here. Make the brush smaller. I'm trying to get over here so you can guys see it happen. Not sure where it is. Let me just get all of them. A couple up here. There it goes. Get them all. Nope, up over here. That's so cool about Marmoset. You can just edit your. I mean, I wish you could make this bigger. There we go. Oh. There we go. Okay, see how that looks. I think I need to make it darker. To be one of these ones over here. Where did it? It takes like a second. It might be because I'm streaming too. It takes a second to catch up with what you I'm just gonna go all full strength. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. pieces. Oh, you know what? I think I back those UVs. Seems to work a little smoother when you're not zoomed in super close. I got 12 of them. Why isn't it doing anything here? Yeah, it's like crushes it here. Let me turn the brush down, lay it out. Yeah, see, it totally did it here. Or maybe not. Weird, it's like it's pulling the seams back together almost. The cage is just so far out on these. I think it's kind of like a vertex painting, where it only can do something where there's like a technically where a vert would be. What? Let's reset it. Let me just get it close. Let me try to do the opposite. Now, as opposed to What are we doing wrong? Looks like I have to hit the edges of these instead of the Let me use my stylus. I don't know why I'm sitting here struggling with my mouse. He doesn't like this stuff. Weird. I think it likes the stylus. Oh. Must be clicking something that's resetting it. Must be a shortcut that I'm not aware of. Oh yeah, that's definitely affecting it. There it goes. You know which one I think I need to find is the inside of the Let me start over. These are the inside. Alton something does that. Yeah, got the insides. Middle button. Something about the this viewport lags behind or something. Oops, I guess I didn't need to do all that much. One here, then. I think it might be partially because I'm streaming. A little taxing on my machine. I mean, between everything going on, you know. Alright, now let's check out the viewport. Looks pretty good, except for here, there, so I need to go the other way. And there we go. Be these. It's weird. But weird, I don't find that. There we go. Define this one. I'm just gonna bunghole on this. Still sticking out a little. Let me turn the flow up. Away. Still sticking out, huh? I don't even know if that matters. Is this the right pieces? Oh my god. Another. No. It wasn't. Piece was that bit of. Oh, it doesn't. It seems like if you zoom, it reactivates the. Weird. Yeah, you definitely got to be a little patient with it. Okay. All right, done. Okay, and then let me just check everything else. See, the bands are good. Yeah, this one needs to come out a little bit. And as I go through, I'm just going to hide the high so that I can see the bake easier after it's done baking. Box looks pretty good. Oh, sticking out just a little bit there. That's Fuck. Okay. It's pretty good. Might need to do a little paint offset. Oops, I'm going the wrong way. Need to go white. There we go, perfect. Here. I think that's it. Oh, this one's still poking out a little lower one. There we go. Oh, and I need right here on the edge. See that sticking out right there? Much. Brush that. Nope, that's the wrong spot. Here, maybe? Try it in the viewport. There we go. You know what else I want to try to do? I want to try to do anything? Oh no, my brush is like tiny. No, let's just see what it's like with like that. All right. I'll have to mess around with paint skew later. What's the last part? The bolts. Oh, those could definitely come in a little bit. Just do a little paint offset. Size this bad boy down. Boom. Same thing on the other side. Okay, turn off the high poly. mounts.
I got it.
Need to turn the high poly off for the lock. Oops. Okay, that. Now for the fun part. Okay, I got it set to where I want to go. Just, yep. And I'm going to set this to 16. I'll leave the padding at moderate. I'm going to go 4K. And for this, I'm going to do vertex color. Curvature, position and height, because I think I'm going to use those in Substance Painter. And roughness? No, I don't think. I think Substance does that on its own. And then over here, you just kind of check it and make sure you check all the ones you want. And I don't need the material ID because that's just my vertex colors. And those were the poly paint from ZBrush. And I'm going to try this setting. That, and I'm gonna do ignore groups because I want it to be like it's one thing. And let's turn that up to, it's probably gonna take a while, floor occlusion. And now let me save. Just in case. And bake. Might take a little bit, but you gotta consider that it's baking all the maps at 4K with the 16x samples. And I kinda cranked up the ambient occlusion. I don't honestly understand all that much. I'm probably wrong, but I think there's probably the default that they have it set at is probably okay for something as simple as this anyway. Go, go, go. Oh man, this is so much more fun than doing the retopology and UVs, man. I'm not sure what happened with my retopology session the other night. I was having a lot of issues. I think I need a new keyboard. I think some of my keys are sticking or not working or something, because I feel like lately I've been having a lot of issues with the shift key and my alt key, which I do hit a lot and hold down a lot. But I think that's what might be happening. I really love the material that Marmoset has. It just looks so, like, it looks like a toy. I don't know, that's kind of like how I wish I could make this look the same, exactly the same in Blender. I am having better luck getting my renders to look similar to Substance Painter now in both Blender and Marmoset, but they don't look identical yet. And from what I understand, they never will. But you can get it close. Slowly but surely. Go, go. Go Substance or go Marmoset. Yeah, I don't know if you've ever tried to bake the maps out in Substance Painter, which is still fast, all things considered. But a 4K map with the anti-aliasing. I don't even know if I'm saying that anti-aliasing or aliasing. I think it's aliasing. Anti-aliasing. Takes forever. Takes forever to bake them. The ambient occlusion and the thickness, I think. Take forever. I'm pretty sure I don't need the thickness. I'm just baking it because I can. This is so much better than explode baking, though. I hated that. You had to set every part of your high poly, low poly model away from each other. Keyframe it in one spot when it's whole, and then move everything and put that another keyframe. And then build your cages. I mean, maybe it's come on improved. I haven't used 3ds Max in a long time. I sure am glad I decided to start using Blender. I mean, it's definitely a little quirky here and there, but it is totally awesome. Boom. Boom. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I just did a good job, man. Yeah, it's sometimes it almost looks like it's the high poly. Holy cow. Look at that. That is really a clean bake. Let's see at the other side, the hinges. That was my biggest concern. I have a feeling they're going to be a little buggy. No, not too bad. Still got a little bit of goofiness there, but I'm not going to worry. The texture will hide that. Brawl, that came out Elena. And then you can mess around if you want and then do a roughness. Oh, that looks good. Specular? Did I do a specular? No. Cavity map. That's the curvature. Oh yeah. It totally exaggerates everything. Love it. It always seems like it's dark. Let's get a brighter one. Here we go. Yeah, that looks good. AO is a little aggressive, but yeah. Kind of want it to be if it's a stylized prop. All right, I'm pretty happy with that. I think that turned out nice. Let me save. I guess I could do a quick render. Let me drop a light in there. Let me get a darker sky. And we'll mess around with a couple lights. I'm pretty terrible at lighting. It's so fun. Marmoset is just so damn fun, man. Pop another one in there. I do wish they had a way to, there probably is a way to lock the orthographic view and this one a little bit orange. I like how it tells you the color with the rays. This one a little bit blue. I want to get it around to this side a little. Now we'll put one right over it. Yeah. Oh, this. I wonder if I turn this into a, let's see, directional. I think I want this one to be a spotlight or omni maybe? No. Let's do spot. See what happens when I turn this one into a something else. I kind of like the directional. Nah, that one I like on maybe Omni. And this one up. Board. There we go. Do a little capture. Get the settings. We're gonna take a screenshot. I might as well take a good one. Capture, image and open. Oops. No, I don't want to do that. Hey, that looks pretty good. Nice and cartoony. Just how I liked it. Alright. Save. Alright. Yeah, that looks really good, man. Alright, now I'm gonna jump in a painter. And just I want to do a test. Okay, I need to do this in OpenGL because that's what Blender likes. Hold me. In the projects. Oh. Oops, no, can I grab it? I just want to, for the sake of it, try to bake it in substance. Okay, and then ambient occlusion. What does that mean? Oh, normal. I'm in. Well, let me get my high poly in here. And I'm going to do 2K. Find it. It should be good. The one thing, one of the things I don't like about Substance is by can't see like the cage, and if you need to do adjustments you have to do it after the fact. Looking pretty good. Here's where it slows down. That ambient occlusion and the thickness really seem to take its toll on the baking process in Substance. This might take a while. Son of a, I should be done this. Oh, maybe not. So. And this is only a 2K map. Didn't even do 4K. I didn't do the 8X sampling stylizing. I don't know why I have a brain fart every time I say that word. Aliasing? Yeah, that, see, the thickness is another one. I do like the environment maps that they have in Substance better than Marmoset. I guess I could just export them. Ooh. Yeah, see, that looks a little funky right there. Yeah, we did on the hinges. Yeah, a little bit of funkiness on the hinges here. Yeah, see, even the. To be fair, this is only a 2K map. Try to clear all the. And. Grab these bad boys. Just drop them in there. I love that you can do that. I wish they just had a thing that said this, all of them. All of these are textures. I mean, I can imagine some people might have a ton of textures, like on a really complex character. And we want to do this to the current session. Right, normal map. No, it should be called chess normal. This. Did I do this? Chest thickness. Yeah, see, I don't have that wonkiness that was there. Back. The hinges just look so much better. But enough of that. Let me just throw a couple textures on here to mess around. You know, let me see what it looks like. The layer. I don't want this to affect that. What's going on? What? Let me look at this. UV. Okay, it's tiling. Don't want that. Too small. Okay. One.
There we go.
Much better. Then, like that one doesn't do much. All right. This I will save for tomorrow. Already been about an hour and I need. I think that looks pretty darn good. Do a test in the iRay, right? X, I see. You know what? It shouldn't be so reflective. Let me. This needs to be more middle. Wait that much. Let's try that. Oof, so pretty crazy. I mean, that is the air. Right? Bloom, to bloom. One doesn't seem to do any fat. What else we got? Cheap lens on that. Standard. Horizontal streak. Bloom's the way to go. Oops. Let me try a different, okay. Environment. Studio 2. That's cool. It is a bummer that Substance doesn't have just a little more options for rendering. Just a little screenshot of that. Just render. All right, and now just for shits and giggles, I'm gonna export this out. I don't know if I've done this right. Followed a thing online, and then I added a bunch of extra ones just in case. See, I need to add maps in here. Need the placement, and I need that. Sure, why not the specular? Specular. Let's see if the ambient occlusion ends up looking different. And I went up. Up res to A. Their projects. And nope, not Corona. Cycles, export. Okay, do a little save. Save as. Yes. All right. Let's go ahead and close that out. Pop Blender back. Just for the sake of trying. New material. Texture. This is a principled shader, even though I didn't really technically make a true PBR texture from what I understand about PBR texture. Node editor. Grab this bad boy, control shift D. SP bakes. And we want. Oops.
I don't want that. I want. Yeah.
Here we'll have cereal. Oh, that looks pretty close. Whoever came up with this Node Wrangler add-on is a friggin' genius. One thing that you have to do is have to import the ambient occlusion yourself. Have to use XRGB. I think that's the right one. Then you drop that into there. And I think you want it to overlay. Oops. Let me replace that. So maybe it's this way. Yeah, there we go. Let's see what it looks like. What? Mix. Oh, definitely not mix. Darken. Oh, it's my, gotta have a HDR. You know what, just curiosity, I want to see what this does. Oh, I thought I made one. Huh. I thought I did a specular. That looks pretty close though, huh? I should have kept substance open. Just delete that. Pop that down. Let me, lane.
And then we'll just go. Let me turn the world down quick. See the H even more? That's the lowest it'll go. See what that ends up looking like. I gotta get better lighting. Whoa. Yeah, because I can't or I don't understand lighting enough, all this looks different in Blender. Definitely looks a lot closer though. You know what, this is gonna take a lot longer. All right. All right, guys, I'm going to call it a night. If you are curious about the rest of this, the creation of this, you can check out my YouTube channel. I'll grab the link here. In the chat. So yeah, if you want to check it out, check me out there. I have a couple other videos that you might be interested in. Some of them are a little mundane, but maybe they'll be helpful. You can see me struggle through the process of learning how to use Substance Painter, Blender, ZBrush, Marmoset. Yeah, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. And hit the subscribe button if you want to stay tuned and get notified for the new videos. Right, you guys have a good night. Jaybro 3D is out.